You can also ask for help. All right, what we got? Oh, this is a good one. Okay, you're lost in the woods. Who would you rather ask for directions? Or who would you trust to ask for directions? The in-tune saxophone player, the out-of-tune saxophone player, or Santa Claus? No, the in-tune saxophone player, because the other two mean you're hallucinating. There you go, get your candy back. That's a good answer. That's a very good answer. But you can actually tune the chainsaw. All right, our guest conductor for the next piece, you may have seen her before. Huh? I know. He's always trying to drink. We've seen this young lady before. This is Christina Edwards. She's a meteorologist on Channel 19. And if you didn't see the other day with doing the weather with her sousaphone on air, I might add, you have not seen that clip. You need to go see that clip. We appreciate her doing the promo for Tuber Christmas and for her volunteering to step up here. And she's going to guest conduct the next piece. Would you like the microphone?
Yes, sir.
You're always supposed to guest host.
Kind of. It's usually a smile. Wow, I'm getting used to it now. Thank you so much. And thank you all so much for coming and supporting Tuber Christmas. I grew up in the Atlanta area, and when I was in high school and college, I used to go down to the CNN Center, and we'd have hundreds of tubas there. We had high school, middle school, as well as college tuba players there. So now that I've moved here to the Rocket City, I'm happy to join the Tuba Christmas crew here,
So if you guys got a double B flat tuba, hold it up, which is most of them. It's going to be most of them. Okay, but some of them are C tubas. So if you've got a C tuba, hold it up. Doesn't look much different, but it plays, but the fingers are completely different. Then we've got an E flat tuba here and there. I think we've got one E flat here. And then we've got an F tuba back over here. So we've got a whole bunch of different keys of tubas that are be playing all once. Now, this is where the tuba player is biased against. They have to learn a different fingering for every single tuba. Clarinet players and saxophone players, they just change the music, so all they have to do is play one set of fingers. They don't have to learn a different set of fingers when they move from alto clarinet to bass clarinet to soprano clarinet to contralto clarinet to soprano saxophone and alto saxophone. It's the same fingers all the way through, which is why we like to make fun of them. Well, that's one reason. That's one of many. Then we have, in the back, what Christina brought today with us is the sousaphone, which you typically see used in marching bands. That, is that the one from James Clements?
Yes, sir.
That sousaphone's on loan from James Clements High School. And James Clements is headed off to London in a few days, right? They're marching in one of the London Christmas parades in London, England, so they're headed off to overseas for a few days. Our next piece is Silent Night, and we always play that. It's not? Apparently it's not. I jumped ahead. So y'all just, we're gonna take two, we're gonna cut the tape and re-edit. What child is this? Everybody knew that, but
thank you.
Engineers might like this one. What's the difference between a jet engine and a trumpet? By about 3 decibels. He wins. Well, actually, the trumpet's louder, but it's still three. It's a 3 decibel difference. Between trumpet players and government bonds. That's pretty good, actually, yeah. But government bonds eventually mature and earn money. Here, this is what I tried to do earlier. The next piece is Silent Night. We always like to take a moment and and we always like to take a moment and use this piece to honor all of those in the armed forces and all of our first responders, especially those who have given the ultimate price. Somebody back here. All right, you're clear there, and I'm going to have to walk. Why, well, this is a good one because we're in church. Why is a French horn considered a divine instrument? It was, actually, yes, but no, because a human blows it, but only God knows what comes out of it. He's calling his lifeline. Do what? No, he got drew one. But that was a good answer, I like that too. Contestant. We're on this side. Oh, there's a gentleman in the back. Saw him first. All right, sir. What do you call a drummer in a three-piece suit? The defendant.
Thank you.
We'd like to thank you for coming out. As he said, this is the 19th year. Two for Christmas started in 1974. The first Two for Christmas on December 22nd was held at Rockefeller Center in New York City. It was set up by Harvey Phillips, who was the tuba teacher at the University of Illinois for years and years and years and years. And he did it in honor of his teacher, William Bell, who was actually born on Christmas Day in 1902. William Bell was one of the preeminent brass teachers of the 20th century that really kind of set the stage for all brass players, regardless of what instrument it might be, throughout the 20th century. His effect, his influence still lives on even today. So that's kind of where Tuba Christmas started. So this is the 43rd year that Tuba Christmas has existed. In the 19th year we've had it in Huntsville. As Philip said, we started out at the Art Museum, and now we're here at Covenant. We are so glad that you're here today. You braved this, this foreign banner falling from the sky. I don't know what this is. It's happening. It's been so long, I forgot what it is. So yeah, we'll talk about her later. But yeah, we have some here that can tell us what that's all about. But we'd like to thank you for coming. Everybody have a good program? Everybody got a program? Because I'm not going to tell you what we're playing, because we got other stuff to do. So you have to figure that out on your own, because that's why we print these things. And we'd also like to ask you to silence all of your electronic devices. And later on, we're going to ask you to even ignore them, which I know is difficult for some of you, but that's just the way it's going to go with it. So, we're going to start out with our first piece of Deste Fidelis. It says I've got a green light. Ah, success. Thank you. What do I do wrong? to one of our Jehovah's Witnesses before. Oh, you're gluttons for punishment, aren't you? We like to do a little thing here now and then for better to the business. We like to educate people. We're all about education. I was a music educator for 35 years. Recently retired. I'm now a music instrument repair technician at Southeastern Musical Services. Well, if you take your horn anywhere else, I'll find you. Take this. But this year, we're two of us will be fine, we'll find out that later. We are going to see what you know about our brother and sister instruments. Flutes, clarinets, et cetera, et cetera. So hopefully some of you like to play along here with us because there are prizes involved. We always like prizes. So, who would like to be my first contestant? All right, ma'am. Why do flute players leave their cases on the dashboard of their cars? We only had an hour. Good answer, but no. So they can park in the handicapped spaces. But participating, she gets a candy cane. Very good answer. Question today, right? Very good answer. But unfortunately, it's for lighting a bassoon. But he gets a candy cane anyway. over here. Come on. All right, we got somebody way back there. Now remember, you can't look at your phones. Now, this is in relation to the last question. Who's raised your hand back there? I lost you on the thing. Okay. Why is a bassoon better than an oboe? No, it burns longer. Some of the questions are related. Yeah, we got a new category this year, and I forgot about it. We had so many people decorate the horns, we decided to have a vote and see who was the most festive player person up here. Both what they wore and decorated their instrument, and hands down, it was unanimous. By acclamation, it is Richard Pearsall. Apologies, Rachel, but it's a new category and I forgot. Thank you. joining us on that was our coordinator, Phil Moore. Big hands for him. All right. Somebody on this side now. That man right here. You can ask for help. He volunteers him. All right. How do you improve the aerodynamics of a clarinet player's car? That's the question, yes. I like that answer. Actually, you take the Domino's pizza sign off the top. Thank you.